Okay, we now move on to speaking part two, and your topic is describe a time you saw children behave badly. Any bad behavior, they were fighting or throwing litter here and there, or any bad behavior in public. Right. In public means at the airport or anything like that.
Right.
You should say, and by the way, describe a time you saw. Saw means past. Exactly. Where it was, location.
Right.
What the children were doing,
right.
Activity, right? How others reacted to that, people's response to it. And explain how you felt about it, your feelings.
Right.
Totally past tense, right? Mm. Please, you can start.
So, I'm a kind of person who believes in that a person's ability, you know, to learn mannerism begins right at the age when he or she is, you know, at the age of young or being youngster. So, I came across an incident recently, a couple of days back. And I was really amazed the way people actually reacted to that situation. So I'm I usually go to park for an evening walk, and I went for a walk, and the children were actually playing over there. And what they were doing was the specific activity was that they were plucking the flowers in the park, and I was really infuriated by that by seeing that. But everyone was so calm and composed that they didn't come to those children, and they didn't stop any of them. But there was one elderly uncle who was very, I guess he was very responsive, and he went to those children, and he started telling them about the importance of plants and how they can, you know, help. How plants are going to help them in future, how the plants are helping them in present as well. So I was really amazed that how he was able to make the best out of that difficult situation. And children actually learned from the lesson the uncle gave.
Okay.
Yeah.
Overall, it was good. But initially, the way you started, you were going to be stuck somewhere.
Yeah.
Mannerism and this and that.
Right, right.
So try to simplify that. But the words you use, they were good. You are speaking fluently. This is your natural style. You don't speak very fast.
Yeah.
But you know, we don't need fast speed. We just need fluent thing. Fluent thing means you don't stop anywhere. You don't do any and all that. So by these means, it's all good. Keep it up. But in the beginning, like, you are going to get stuck. If you get stuck, your band score goes down quickly.
Yeah.
So don't come up with anything where you are likely to be stuck.
Right.
Now we go on, and we have speaking part three. What bad behavior do children usually have?
I don't have children at home. I mean, but there are few. I have few cousins, and I have quite experienced few things from them. Is that I just missed the question.
Yes, actually.
Yes, I tell you.
Just relax. Whenever you answer the question directly.
Okay,
if you go to indirect answer, then you will forget the question.
Right.
Because your brain is working on what you are speaking.
Right.
So it's difficult for the brain to retain that.
Right.
Now, what bad behavior do children usually have? Start with that. Children usually shout at each other, which is really considered a bad behavior, first of all.
Right.
On the other hand, some children from some areas, they use abusive language, which is also considered a very bad behavior. Moreover, some children snatch things from each other. That is also one of the behaviors which are not considered as good ones.
Right.
Okay? Keep it simple. And don't always start with a background thing. And then you come back to
especially
the question.
In this part, I guess.
Yes.
Yeah.
Let's go on. How should parents stop their children from behaving badly at public?
I guess children, parents shouldn't have any sort of double standards, and they should actually teach their children to be good in whether they are in public or they are in private. So I guess what matters is that how the parents are going to teach their children.
Okay, so you can just add some more to it, right?
Yeah.
So in speaking, I would advise you to be direct.
Right.
And to come up with the simple ideas,
right.
Which you can elaborate easily, right? I mean, you have the ability to score 7 or above, but now I'll give you 6.5, okay?
Right.
Yes.